Hello students, we are back again in our mathematics class. I hope all of you are well at home and you are enjoying our online classes every day, and you have submitted me the worksheets. I have checked it. You have learned it very well. So today our topic is long division and vocabulary of division from the chapter Can We Share. First of all, today we are going to discuss about what we know about division. What we know about division? Division is one of the basic operation among four basic operation. What are the four basic operations? You know that. That is addition, subtraction, multiplication, and last one is division. So already we have learned about addition, how to add, how to subtract, how to multiply. Now we will learn about division. So, the name of the chapter, we can easily understand that can we share means share, distribute. These are the words we can use for division. So, and also you can consider the sign of division. The sign of division is similar with which operation? It is similar with the operation subtraction. That's why division can be represented as repeated subtraction. For example, if we want to divide 8 by 2 with the help of repeated subtraction, then what we have to do? First of all, here the number of steps is the answer of the division. So we have to divide repeatedly from the given number. See, I have subtracted 2 from 8 first step and I got 6. Then what number comes? That from that number we have to subtract 2 again. Then it is we get 4. Then again 4 minus 2 equals to 2. 2 minus 2 equals to 0. So in 4 step we have completed our answer. So the answer is 4, because 4 steps are involved there. So now we need to learn about the vocabulary of division. The terms used in division are divisor, dividend, quotient, and remainder. Now we will learn about the function of these 4 different terms. What are the uses of these terms in division? Now we need to understand about divisor, dividend, quotient, and remainder. As I told before that division is one of the basic operation, so we can use this operation word and we can easily understand that or remember the function of divisor and dividend. In practical life, the doctors operate the patient and the patients whom we operate. So now the two kids are very confused about divisor and dividend. As I told before that the doctor operate the patient and the patient whom we operate. So here in division also, divisor operate the division and the patient is like our dividend, whom we operate. So dividend is the number you are dividing and divisor is the number dividing by. For example, if we were to divide 44 by 4, then we can say that 4 is the divisor, as 4 is operating the operation division and 44 is the dividend, because we want to divide 44 by 4. So the number you are dividing, that is our dividend. So 44 is the dividend and 4 is the divisor. Now you can easily understand what is divisor and what is dividend. Now we are are very confused about quotient and remainder. What is mean by quotient and what is mean by remainder? Very tough question it is. No, it is not yet tough. You just observe the operation. Already I have told that divisor helps to operate the operation and dividend helps to dividend whom is the number whom we operate. Now the quotient is the answer, means the quotient is the answer of division, means after operation the recovered patient, we can say that who is recovering, that patient is called as quotient. And remainder is the leftover after division means sometime after division some numbers can remain. Remainder means remain. From remain we can say that remainder. So remain means left. So here the word remainder used for left over after division, like 42 divided by 2, then 22 is the quotient and here nothing will be remained, so the remainder is 0. Now we will learn about long division and the steps of long division. Now let us learn about the steps of long division method. See, our first step is divide, means we need to divide. Our second step is multiply. Now after division we need to multiply. Then third step is subtract, then bring down, then repeat the process until you get zero. So the step, again I am repeating, divide, multiply, subtract, bring down, repeat. Now I will give you one example, and from example you can easily understand how to divide. See here, the 100 is divided by 4, so 100 is the divisor. Now we can understand that our first step is divide. So we have to divide it by 4. So first number is 1. 1 is less than 4. So 4 zeros we need to subtract. So we have to take the less number from 1. So 4 zeros are 0. Then subtract. Then bring down. So we have multiply already. Our second step also done. Now we have to subtract. 1 minus 0 equals to 1. Now we have to bring down 0. So after bringing down 0, see it became 10. So 4 2s are 8. So 10 minus 8 equals to 2. Again bring down 0, then 20. So 4 5s are 20. So this way you can divide. Now we will divide. We have to divide 402 by 3. See, 3 is the divisor and 402 is the dividend. Whenever you have to ask for division, you need to write the terms divisor, dividend, quotient and remainder. See, 4 is divided by 3. So how many 3s are there in 4? Only 1 3s are there in 4. So 3 1s are 3. So 4 minus 3 equals to 1. Now bring down 0. Then 10, 3 3s are 9. Then subtract 1 2 12. Then 3 4s are 12, so the remainder came 0, so our answer is complete. So the quotient is 134 and the remainder is 0. In this way, if we follow the steps, we can easily understand long division. You have to practice, you no need to jump any step and no need to avoid any step. Okay, so now let us consider the next question. So the question is, we have to divide 753 by 6. So first we have to take the 100 plus number 7. As 7 is greater than 6, so 6, how many 6 are there in 7? There are 1 6, maximum 1 6. So 6 1s are 6. Now subtract, 7 minus 6 equals to 1. Now bring down the next number, that is 5. So 15 then 6 2s are 12, 6 3s are 18. So we have to take 12 as 18 is more than 15. So 6 2s are 12, then subtract again, that is 3. Now bring down the next number 3, that means 33. So 6 5s are 30, 6 6s are 36. 36 is more than 33, so we have to take 30, then subtract, that is 3. Now we no need to subtract or divide, so it is our answer. Now in this question is for you. Those who will understand this question, please write the answer in the comment section. That is, I have done two same division, but there are so the you have to choose which answer is incorrect and which is correct. So observe the question carefully. So you have to follow the steps for long division. That is, first divide, multiply, subtract, then bring down and repeat until you get zero. So this is our step. If you not following the steps, then you will face problem. So you have to follow the steps in the beginning of learning of long division. So learn it well and practice it, and do let me know in the comment section what is your answer.